Hello, friend. Welcome back to Locally Raised. Today is pickle day. I've got cucumbers steadily coming in. Last week I brought you along for a tour of the garden and I said that I thought we'd be ready for pickles in a couple weeks. I was wrong. It's time now. I want to get these preserved before anything goes bad in the fridge. So join me for canning some dill pickles this morning. I'll share three tips for making sure that your pickles stay crisp. If you haven't canned before or haven't made pickles before, this is a very user-friendly recipe and process. I think you'll find it pretty doable. These are pickling cucumbers, so they're the kind that is ideal for making pickles. They're distinct because they have a thinner skin than other cucumbers, which is good if you want to can whole pickles, then the brine can penetrate that thin skin. And they also have a firmer flesh, which helps them stay crisp. However, you can make pickles from any type of cucumber. Picking it while it's young and tender is best. The first step is to wash your cucumbers and then to scrub off all those little prickles around the outside. Every little bump has its own set of prickly, hairy bits that come off of it. And so I've found that using the rough end of a sponge works best for this, but you definitely want to get these off. I'm creating an ice bath here. Two things we're going to do first to make sure our pickles stay crisp is cut off the blossom end of each cucumber and then soak the cucumbers in an ice bath for an hour. The blossom end of the cucumber has enzymes that break down the flesh of the cucumber, and that's what can make a pickle mushy. I've actually cut off a little bit more than I should have here. Here it's easy to tell which is the blossom end because it still had a blossom on it, but often that's not the case. So to help you identify the blossom end of the cucumber, it's usually the smaller end of the cucumber. It's generally lighter colored and it has a smaller sort of circular scar than the stem end. For example, here this darker end with the larger circle is the stem, and over here is the blossom end. So I'm just going to cut the slightest bit off to remove that end. With all the blossom ends cut off, the cucumbers are left to sit in their ice bath for about an hour. While those cucumbers are soaking, I'm going to start gathering the supplies that we need for our pickles. It really doesn't take a whole lot of ingredients to make these. You'll need a salt that's safe for canning. I usually use my Redmond Real Salt, but I'm out right now, so fortunately my mom had this. Any salt that isn't iodized and doesn't have anti-caking agents will be good for canning. You'll need some distilled white vinegar. Garlic is optional. I like a garlicky pickle. That's up to you. This is from my garden. This is the stuff that needs to be used right away because the head has burst open. It's not good for preserving. So perfect that we're using this today. And then finally, some dill. The bloom and the fronds, I don't know what to call them. The bloom and the foliage have slightly different flavors, so it's great to be able to use some of each. But if you're not growing your own dill or your dill hasn't bloomed yet, don't worry about it. You can just use this. I know this is much easier to find at the grocery store. I did not have much luck with my dill this year. It looks terrible. It's just kind of a brown twig right now. So fortunately my mom's doing better than I am and doesn't mind giving some to me.
The last ingredient is another optional one, and that's strawberry leaves.
These are the final secret to a crisp pickle. So cutting off the blossom end, soaking in ice water, and then adding something with tannins helps to keep things crisp. This is my first year giving this a try, and I'm excited to see what it's like. I have learned this trick from the online canning community. I've read a bunch of people. Several people have said that they swear by this for keeping their pickles crisp. So I'm glad to have one more thing I can do to get that nice pickly crunch. Those cucumbers still need about half an hour in their ice bath, so let's get started with making the brine. That's four and eight. Two and a quarter cups white vinegar. And half a cup pickling salt. I'm just heating and stirring until all the salt is dissolved. Next, I'm going to crush these cloves of garlic. I'll put one crushed clove in the bottom of each jar. This was my first year growing garlic, and it feels really cool to be using my own garlic with my own cucumbers for pickling. As I was looking at people's recommendations for crisp pickles, one of the recommendations was to process the cucumbers immediately, so within 24 hours of harvesting. For me, if I'm using my own cucumbers, that just doesn't work. I can't pickle them every day, which is what that would require. So I haven't had issues in the past with using cucumbers that have been refrigerated a couple days. That's how I... Anyhow, I was saying I think it works just fine to use cucumbers that have been refrigerated for a couple days, but if you are having trouble with your pickles not getting crisp enough, that's one thing you could try. Some of these cloves are pretty big. I think I'll smash it, but count on a half clove in each jar when the cloves are this big. This was German garlic, which is a variety that tends to get large. I'm really satisfied with it. I think I'll grow that one again. It'd be cool to save my own garlic cloves to replant, but I also kind of don't want to give up that garlic. I want to eat all of it. We'll see if I end up buying cloves next year or starting from some of my own. All right, all the garlic's peeled. I'm gonna smash these cloves so that they can release their flavor into the pickles. If I wind up having more than I need, I will not be sorry at all to have cloves already smashed in a bag in the fridge. Peeling garlic is just one of the things that keeps me from using it more in my cooking. Wow, fresh garlic smashes more easily. I guess it's different when it hasn't been cured. That makes sense. It's just softer. The cucumbers have had their hour to soak, so I'm gonna start slicing them to get them ready to pack into jars. I'm gonna start with sorting these into groups that are similar sized. It's gonna be easier to pack them into jars if I've got like sizes together. They'll just fit nicely. These all match together. I'm gonna cut these into spears because we most often use pickles as snacks.
I've got a few cucumbers here that are larger than the rest. This one especially, I just was one of those that was hiding in the vines and I didn't notice it until it was bigger than I'd like. I don't think this is gonna fit conveniently as a sphere into my pint-sized jars. So I'm gonna do a few chips. I think that'll be nice for days when we have burgers. We mostly snack on pickles, but we also use them on burgers. So I'll get one or two pints of chips yet. You can see this one's over mature. See that hole? That's what happens when it gets overripe. Most of them don't look like that though, so that's okay. I'm gonna use them anyways. Chips and spears are ready to pack in jars. Start heating that brine again and get my jars out of the dishwasher. I was just about to start packing the cucumbers into jars when I realized I don't have hot water in my canner yet. So I'm gonna fill up my canner and get it on the stove because we are going to be water bath canning these and I want that water to be hot and ready for when the pickles get lowered in. Then we'll start packing those jars. I've got my assembly line set up here to make things easier for myself. So I'm going to put a strawberry leaf and some crushed garlic in the bottom of each jar. Then I'm going to tightly pack in the cucumbers and top off with some dill bloom and some dill leaf. That gave me four jars of spears. Now I'm gonna move on to the chips. Those can be packed in however you like. Again, the idea is just to pack it full, pack it tight.
Now that all the jars are packed, it's time to soak my lids. I'm just soaking them in a bit of warm water to help activate their seal.
And we're ready to fill our jars. Hi, baby girl. Yes, I hear you. The jars need to be filled to a half inch of headspace. A good rule of thumb just to eyeball things is to go to this middle ring. Baby girl. That brine worked up to just the right amount for 8 pints, so I'm glad I didn't try to make any more. I'll flip you around and show you what's left of it. There's just the smallest bit left, and I might need to top off some of these jars, so that's perfect. Next, I'm gonna debubble. With jars like this, where you have a lot of solid substance packed in, it's definitely important to go through this step because there can be air bubbles trapped in the jar, which will affect processing. It's important that those are worked out so that things can be heated evenly so that food safety is maintained. With the chips, it's not so bad because they aren't able to pack super tight, but with these spears, they are packed tight and there's definitely air trapped in there. So you just work your way around, pressing from the outside into the middle. Now that all the air bubbles are knocked out, I'm gonna check for my half inch of head space. So that's this second notch here. And I want the tip to just be touching the surface. So some of these are gonna need to be topped off. Next, I've got a bit of water in here. I'm gonna add a splash of vinegar. And then I'm just gonna use a paper towel. Sorry, this baby is so chatty right now. A paper towel to wipe each of these surfaces down, or each of these rims down, to remove any residue that could interfere with the seal. Yes, yes, we hear you, baby. Yes, yes. And then my lids have been soaking in that warm water, which helps to activate their seal. Just gonna gently set them on top. And then we'll tighten these bands to fingertip tight.
Next, I'm just loading my jars into the rack so that they can be lowered into the canner. Often the jars are put onto the rack with the rack propped on top of the canner, but I have just knocked the rack down and splashed hot water on myself too many times, so I like to load them outside. The jars should have about an inch of water above them. And then once this returns to a full boil, it'll process for 15 minutes. So I'll set a timer then for 15 minutes. It's time to get these out. I'm really hoping everything seals. So these have had 15 minutes of full boil time, and then we turned, well, John turned the stove off. I was busy. And they had 5 minutes to sit. I always give my jars 5 minutes to sit afterwards so that the temperature could come down gradually, because the thing that you want to avoid is shocking your jars with the cold. That's also why when your jars come out of the canner, they need to sit on something like a towel, or I'm going to use a cutting board. You don't want to put them on a cold countertop. That shock could shatter the jar. Love that sound. Oh, there's another one. Thanks for joining me for a morning of pickle making. These need 2 weeks to sit in that brine and fully become pickles. So I'm eager to try them, but I'm gonna have to wait a little bit. I think I'm gonna make bread and butter pickles in a couple days. We've got lots of cucumbers coming in right now, and bread and butter pickles are my husband's favorite. Dill is my favorite. So I'll make something for him next time. I'll post that on Instagram, and we're harvesting and preserving things every day right now. So if you want to see what that daily process looks like, you can see updates on Instagram at locally.raised. I look forward to sharing more with you next week, and I'll see you then. Bye.